Thank you for joining us live on the air.
My pleasure.
It was a place where everything was legal.
Television, the drug of a nation. Raining ignorance and feeding radiation on television. The drug of a nation. Breeding ignorance and feeding radiation. Its satellite links are United States of unconsciousness. Apathetic, therapeutic, and extremely addictive. The methadone metronome, pumping out 150 channels 24 hours a day. You can get through all of them.
Television are convinced that the ability to portray immediacy, to realize what's new, what's going on, is the true significance of this new communication bridge.
The average family watches television over 7 hours a day. This is voluntary enslavement.
ZooTV.
Okay.
ZooTV.
I'm ready. I'm ready for the laughing gas.
Hello, my friends. I mean you. You are here because you are interested in the unknown, the mysterious, the unexplainable.
Welcome to ZooTV. I'm David Saltz, and we're down here in the underworld. This is the show, Believe the Show, and what happens down here is really amazing. It's where 327 tons of equipment wreck the ZooTV mammoth set. It comes off of 64 trucks with a crew of 500 guys that load it together, and we're going to show you around a little bit. Right up here on stage right, you can see where Edge's guitars emanate from. Dallas in there, off in hands Edge, jiggling one of three guitars that he uses in the show tonight. Then the sequencing takes place here. The sound you're hearing right now in Zoo Station, that industrialized sound, gets sequenced right here for Dave. And we make our way back here. It's very expansive, yeah, very compact place. Right here is the electrical source. 42,000 kilowatts of power emanate out of these boxes. And no smoking down here, we'll tell you that.
See the thugs and the third rate move into the seats of power.
The transforming power of technology is our pride and our neurosis.
Harry, fix the TV.
People are suffering from future shock. Future's arriving so fast that they're having difficulty coping with it.
It's no secret that the stars are falling from the sky. It's no secret that our world is in darkness tonight. They say the sun is sometimes eclipsed by a moon. You know I don't see you. She rocks at home. It's no secret that a friend is someone that's at home. It's no secret that a liar.
Yeah. all of this sounds like science fiction or cyberpunk, but it's not. It's real.
Put your hand against the screen here.
Good evening, I'm Rex Fox for Zoo News in New York. The category is athletics. Born in Czechoslovakia in 1901 with a free game card, the antibiotics arrived too late for thousands of satisfied motorists. An all-night vigil by protesters met with a year's free subscription. Call toll-free for ex-government salad sandwiches with a choice of fillings. Older ladies may prefer Beaver playing the decade of dance in a crisis currency debate. All these are stories
of the future. Data of every description will pervade our consciousness. Holograms projected beneath our eyelids. Direct retinal stimulation.
Hey! Hey! New York! New York!
ZooTV? You've made the right choice.
Hey!
The sad with the
orange. Is the best of yours.
And now,
let's go to Bono on stage.
So, let's watch some TV, shall we? You can never find the commercials when you need them.
Typical American television.
Yeah, I'm definitely going through my Fat Elvis period. Next! What's this, the Emmys or something?
Deborah Rogers. I think this must be...
Thank your mother and get it over with.
She
I'm a working mother with two children successfully transplanted to a blind woman down 51 points to 9.59, a shameless crowd pleaser at low temperatures, narrowly escaped bankruptcy the size of the ozone hole. Got myself a 44 Magnum with extra mountain aroma. Some invertebrates have digestive tracts based on T.S. Eliot's poems with no tangible essence. How soft can you get?
We're just talking about basic television programs.
Yeah. Well, one of the effects of television is to remove people's private identity. They become corporate, peer group people just by watching it.
With Shakalaka with the U2 ZooTV tour, co Public Enemy Front with the BAD, co Dynamite, rocking nonstop with the sequence on Bono's face. Yo!
Mysterious ways. All right.
On ZooTV. He seems to get closer and closer every night.
He touched me tonight.
Where did he touch you?
Well, right here. Kind of,
did he leave that mark?
No, he's going to grab my jewel one night.
I had to do it, you see. I couldn't help myself. I'd seen him so many times on television. Groupie or anything like that, but I had to breathe the same air as him. I had to move in his space. I don't know. I looked around. Looked around the room. My heart was beating so fast. I moved over to his bed.
I'm Rona Elliott here live in Dublin, Ireland, where within the hour you will be seeing U2 live. Follow me and you can see what is expected to be the most significant and exciting TV event since the Gulf War. Now, ZooTV is being broadcast right now live to 32 countries around the world, and there are commentators and translators in this room speaking in many languages. As you can see, they're here, Italian, Scandinavia, Holland and Germany. Let's listen. Okay, now the band have been on the road since last March, and they have just come home here to Dublin this weekend. Ireland's just had an election. They've just had a big hero's welcome. They've offered to be, Bono has offered to be the prime minister. So far, none of the politicians have responded. So in the spirit of homecoming in this live ZooTV broadcast, we'll be back later. Let's go first to Rex Fox at ZooTV.
Thank you, Rona. Amid rumors of stubborn stains, our fresh fruit contestants cut a third of the workforce today, leaving voters in no doubt it's the extra month on the tree gives your dog prolonged active life. No other cold remedy stops pain faster in the remote townships with improved cornering stability and the sheer luxury of better prostate health with a delicious low-fat lasagna. These are my son's shorts, two endangered species keeping up with the latest dance trends, taste buds tingling with emergency relief efforts in the wake of previously unseen footage of Elvis. Here's David Salt.
Thanks, Rex. We're back here on top ZooTV outside broadcast, one of the highest points of the arena. We're watching the band as they rip into Until the End of the World, the title song for the Avengers movie.
Last time we met was a low-lit room. We was close together as bride and groom. We ate the food, we drank the wine. Everybody having a good time. To me, I'm still talking about the end of the world.
advertising is heading is quite simply into a world where the ad will become a substitute for the product, and all the satisfactions will be derived informationally from the ad, and the product will be merely a number in some file somewhere.
And we're back here in New York live with all of the fellows in U2 here on the Global Satellite Network. We're going to go to the phones again. And our next caller is named Bill. He's from Little Rock, Arkansas. Bill, what's your last name? Bill?
Clinton.
Bill Clinton?
Yeah, I'm doing a big job interview in America.
This is Bono here. How do you want us to call you? Do you want to call us, should we call you Governor or Bill?
No, you call me Bill.
All right. And you can call me Betty.
I smoked pot in college, but I didn't inhale.
All the action.
Going up on stage.
When it came with the bottle of champagne, I knew it.
Yeah! Who are you?
I can't talk.
Who's a better dancer, Bono or John Travolta?
Oh, definitely John Travolta.
All right, can you look at this whole thing that's going on stage and say, well, that's my little bit?
Sorry?
Let me rephrase that.
Which particular little bit?
Can you look at this whole thing that's going on stage and say, well, part of this is my creation, part of this was my idea?
Definitely not.
So they cut you out cold.
Absolutely.
What you're saying.
Yeah, I'm doing it for the money.
We've stumbled onto a sad story here.
Yeah.
Do you think that the audience is getting something out of this? Do you think that they're seeing something new? Do you think it's stimulating their imagination?
Yeah, they're coming to a rock and roll gig and watching television. I think that, that's what more can you ask for?
It's a Lou Reed song. Things like that drive me out of my mind. I watched it for a little while. I love to watch things on TV.
Of New York appears on the giant video screens high above Bono in the place where he belongs, always looking over your shoulder.
Lou Reed, I've been told that you've been born life on the moon. Harry Martin John. Monday and Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday. Satellite's gone way up to the sky. Things like that drive me out of my mind. Oh, I watched it for a little while. I love to watch things on ZooTV.
After this.
Thank you.
We're in the Gulf, in Iraqi territory. I'm commanding a tank. We're about to engage with the enemy. We've got a couple of Scud launchers to destroy and about a half a dozen. Right now, we're approaching an Iraqi tank, and this is the view from the tank. We've got radar to the right. We've got fuel gauge. We've got display of weaponry. We've got... This is the main one. It's incredible how it brings out a whole other part of your personality you just weren't aware of. You just want to kill as many of the enemy as you can in as short a space of time. You get completely detached from the concept of somebody being killed. It's just like, well, it is a game. But in a weird way, it's so sinister. I think there is a blur between what's real now and what's make-believe or what's synthetic reality. And I don't know what you can do about that, you know? That's where we're at. This feels very real. Some of the pilots coming back from their operations talking about the difference between their simulators and the real thing, and they're really excited about the fact that it looked real, which I thought was kind of a weird thing to say, as if it would in some ways be just another version of simulated reality. There's one more tank. Once he's knocked out, we move on to level two. There he is. We're closing in now. Yes. Mission complete. You always remember your first kill.
Stop! Homeless man in a major U.S. city was accosted by a group of aggressive young males. They stripped him, spray painted the word scum onto his back, threw him into a garbage dumpster, set it on fire, and pounded the sides while he burned to death.
Streets with eyes painted red, under Thanksgiving Day, November 28th, 1986. Thanks for the wild turkey and passenger pigeons destined to be fed out through wholesome American guts. Thanks for a continent to despoil and poison. Thanks for Indians to provide a modicum of challenge and danger. Thanks for vast herds of bison to kill and skin, leaving the carcasses to rot. Thanks for bounties on wolves and coyotes. Thanks for the American dream to vulgarize and falsify until the bare lies shine through. Thanks for the KKK for nigger killing lawmen feeding their nachos. For decent church-going women with their mean, pinched, bitter, evil faces. Thanks for Kill a Queer for Christ stickers. Thanks for laboratory AIDS. Thanks for prohibition and the war against drugs. Thanks for a country where nobody is allowed to mind his own business. Thanks for a nation of finks. Yes, thanks for all the memories. All right, let's see your arms. You always were a headache, and you always were a bore. Thanks for the last and greatest betrayal of the last and greatest of human dreams.
ZooTV live broadcast. Just a few statistics. You may or may not know, U2 started their tour in March, the first leg of their two-year tour. So far in America, they played to 3 million people. Achtung Baby, their current album, has sold 10 million copies. They've sold a whopping 600,000 t-shirts, and they will pick up the second leg of their tour in May 93. And they will be joining us here live in the studio in just a few minutes from now. And we'll be right back after these messages. And And welcome back. I'm Rona Elliott, and we are live from Dublin, Ireland with ZooTV. And one of the things we're going to be doing tonight, as the live broadcast goes out to 32 countries, is meeting one of Ireland's premier broadcasters. And his name is Pat Kenny. He hosts a TV show here in Dublin once a week. He's a very formidable gentleman. And now we're going to Pat Kenny in the studio.
That's exactly what Bono said when he arrived back from Mexico on Friday. I want to be Taoiseach. Now, you know that you too have been involved in a tour all across the United States, and indoors and outdoors, massive crowds with their ZooTV extravaganza. They're back in town, as I said. They're also with us tonight in this studio, and I don't know whether success has gone to their heads or not, but boy, have they changed. With a track from Achtung Baby, will you welcome, please, you too.
Excuse me. We're on live TV here, you know.
We're on live TV, and of course, we're going to try to sort out what's going on for you.
Excuse me, sir. We're on live TV, and we're going to try to sort out what's going on. Now we're going to go to David Sauls. David, can you hear me? David Sauls, can you clear up what's going on, David?
Yeah, but
take
don't
it
go
away,
to,
David.
Don't go to me. I don't have anything. I have color bars. Don't. I can't. Don't. Guys, what am I supposed to do? This thing doesn't work. I don't know. I don't know if it's the monitor. Yeah, it's the car. I don't know what's wrong with it. I don't know what. We have the only camera. To the studio. I don't know where it is. We're going to the studio. We got to go right now. We're supposed to get to the studio. Everything's gone down. They have a satellite problem. We were supposed to go to the Pete Kenny show. I don't know where it is. I've got to try to find it. We got to go down there now, though. I don't know. Who knows? Where's the Pat Kenny show? Sir, where's the Pat Kenny show? Okay, we're supposed to go into the Pat Kenny show right now. I solved the problem with the satellite. All right, here we are. The Pat Kenny show. You guys can get the shot of the band. I don't know. What's going on here? I don't know. This is. Hey, wait a minute. That's not Bono Swagger. Who are these guys? Put it down. What's going on here? Are you Pat Kenny? Pat Kenny?
That's me. Yeah.
Well, what's going on here? This is you too. Is this a television rating stunt or something?
I know these guys.
There's the real band.
This is my
can we get a word?
Hey, this is my studio. Can we get a word with you? Yeah, but we need to get an interview for ZooTV. Come on, I don't care who you are. Bono, can we get an interview with you for ZooTV? This is their hometown. This is my hometown. Please, Adam, Bono, can we just talk to ZooTV just for a moment? Come on, they're my edge. Just a word. Anything.
I don't know what's going on here, but it's total. It's totally ridiculous. We had a band here. It was a fake U2.
Yeah, so
we come out here to interview a band. That's a boy, all the way from America.
Look, you're wearing this thing. You know what ZooTV is. We did a little ZooTV tonight, and you don't like it, okay?
No, I don't like it when I fly to America, fly economy, stay in a bad hotel here in Dublin, and then come on, and it's a bad Irish joke.
Okay.
We have better gags in America.
Okay, you've better gags. I've got my guests to talk to. Okay, goodbye.
Welcome.
It's great to have you back, fellas.
Thank you.
Will you explain to everybody who doesn't know what's ZooTV?
With high orbit gamma ray pepperoni and cheese, before sex sells complete devastation of the Amazon rainforest. Philadelphia, here I come. This has been Bob Evans for ZooTV News in Miami.
I'd like to say that I still believe in moral absolutes based upon an eternal transcendent being who is the creator of all things, and I'm not talking about Elvis.
What's your vision?
I have a vision!
Let's call George one last time. What do you say? That's 1-2-0-2-4-5-6-1-4-1-4. Okay.
White House.
Hello, is that the White House?
Yes.
Hi, could I speak to President George Bush, please?
He's not available, sir.
George isn't available, but it's our last night. Hello? Could I leave a message for George?
Your message is taken this time, and I heard.
Hello? Could I leave a message for George?
You need to call back on Monday.
I was just gonna say I wouldn't be bothering him from now on. Like, I'm gonna be bothering Bill Clinton now.
Thank you.